good morning, good evening, good afternoon, wherever this video might find you. Today we have a new client. His name is Prescott. He is a standard poodle that Mama wants me to do a doodle cut. Now, since doodles are not recognized, there's really no such thing as a doodle cut, but I'm going to do what I do to my doodles, which is a 5/8 of an inch. I do my 5/8 blade, which is this wonderful blade right here. It is also considered a zero comb or yellow comb. This little thingy. But this is Scott. Say hey, Prescott. He's a very small poodle. He's actually smaller than my Winston, so I don't know if he's... I haven't looked at his age, so I don't know if he's still a puppy. But Mama wants just a top knot. I don't know if she necessarily wants a clean face. But I know she said she wanted the ear shorter. Now, he does have some matting on the bottom of his ear, so I'll probably have to shave part of it. And then I'll probably just edge them. But we're going to do a 5/8 everywhere else. She does not want clean feet. She wants normal feet. So, but it does look like he got a clean face last time. So, I do too. I have to look at the paperwork when he gets that little spot. Sorry, buddy. You can sit. Sit down. Get up. Come on. Come on. You can sit. Relax. There you go. You can lay down if you want. But it takes off about that much hair, which is about that much. Short, but still kind of fluffy, more of a tender kind of look. It's probably taking about literally half of what he has. So this is half off. Sometimes you'll get people that come in that don't mind their dogs getting wet. And then sometimes some people are just like, no, I don't want a wet dog in my car. So. You might actually, I think my Winston is just a little bit bigger than him. Not much though. Now we're going to do his tail the same length, Jim. Yeah.
rainy days do make me feel a little sleepy, man. Some of these days you really just want to lay in bed and sleep a little longer, or just curl up in your bed. If you're a reader, you know, with a book, or, you know, just watch Sleepless in Seattle, or You've Got Me. One of those sappy love movies. I love those movies. They're really, really nice. I can watch Sleepless in Seattle, or You've Got Me, numerous times. They're just that good. Some people are just doing remakes and stuff. But they can't come up with their own stuff. But they probably already even did. carbonated it, okay? Somebody should, you just get so invested in. Carpet in a sense. That kind of gives you an idea of the texture. Just side one more time before I push forward to the front. Back legs, do all the back. So this way, I get the front, and I just gotta do the front. Shave the front area with the tin. Sensitive. So if they are sensitive, I would recommend doing a number 10. If you want to meet the baby hoe, go with the 10. Never go over the booty hole, go around it. Because they can pucker, and then you can cut the butthole. And then you're going to go keep licking it, and then it'll probably turn into an infection. Then if it's a pimple, you know, it's going to hurt or burn. So accidents do happen, though. So you know, if you can, you know, try not to cut all up in there. Careful when you're doing the round foot. Careful with the side of the pad. Because when you're going around with the scissors, this part here can cut underneath the pad and slice it. And at that point, it might need either glue or stitching. So the pad, more like a, I don't want to say like a, it's more like a leathery kind of skin. So glue is most likely to work the bed probably in a week. So if you can avoid cutting that at all costs, I would say that. Like I said, accidents do happen, but don't use that as an excuse if you're trying to cut around it. Just make sure you're brushing your hair up. Just so you can see where hairs you need to cut and you're cutting them. Thinners they blend it a lot better. Chunkers, you can use chunkers, but you gotta be careful with those. With certain textures, it will leave those teeth in there. Like to cut the underside close. You know, that's where the poop comes out. And this way, if it gets all over the tail, it's a lot easier for the owner to clean. Now I have the catheter on that's got constant diarrhea. Medicine, so it subsides. I constantly have to wash her bottom. I'm gonna end up shaving her back in. So it's a little bit easier to clean. Make sure you're brushing it up so you can see from both sides. Because when a doggy walk behind, you're going to see the hair that sticks out, and when someone's walking towards you, they can see any hairs that stick out. Now, some people, if you don't have a groomer's eye, you might not even notice that. But, I mean, sometimes you don't need to have a groomer's eye to see hair sticking out. Take pride in your work, that's all. Herman can be very overwhelming at times. We can get burnt out from, you know, learning all the time. And lose your, you know, your drive to want to learn. And I've hit that stump a few times where it's like, you know, sometimes I just don't want to learn. Sometimes it's like, you know, you don't want to learn.
Same thing for us. Same thing for us, for her.
But, you know, you just gotta find a reason to, you know, revamp why you're doing whatever it is you're doing in your life, in your career. What I love to do is to revamp me up. So I always watch videos. Constantly watching. And try to implement some of the videos that I watch into my rooms. Sometimes I can't replicate what they do. I'm not gonna lie, I can't. No matter how hard I try. But you know, I keep trying. That's all I can do. On the belly, especially in the summertime. If the owner has a tile or carpet floors, basically anything that's not carpet, you can lay on it and then they can get cooled off a little bit quicker. So that's why. Come here, Prescott. Come here, Prescott. He's like, no. Careful when you throw it because it throws because it has some flaps. If you get in between the blades, you can cut it. I've seen it happen a lot. I've got it. Just be careful. Bottle. Walmart, Sally's Beauty Supply, Tractor Supply, Amazon, Walmart, I don't know if it said Walmart. Get there. Any African hair supply. Any other hair place that you might have it. Oh, well, that's good. I'm using a lot of hair sometimes. I'm not even a lot. I like you a lot. You're a very chill poodle. I dig it. Do you sleep with your legs up in the air too? Mine does that. He likes to lie on his back with his legs kicking up. He cracks me up. Can you sit up for me? Come on. long nursery, Mr. Van. Come in the long nursery.
Thank you.
never really seen a bad poodle. Except for maybe like the ear collection. Very rarely get an aggressive poodle. I'm not saying they don't exist. I used to groom ones back when I was in Ohio to shoot a toy poodle. Definitely had a lot of trauma. First time I did it, she bit the living crap out of my hand. I get stitches. I continued to groom when I wrapped up my little boo-boo and I finished her up. I was the only one that would touch her. Especially with time, I mean, she was so snippy. But there would be times where I can actually do it without a muzzle. I try to do her as long as I could without the muzzle, and I know she was working. Yes, I did, so she just wouldn't have it, and I would just have to. I didn't want to say either. She passed away not long ago. I still talk to the moms. Little Miss Julie. She's a little black toy poodle. I love that little snapper. Scooping this one near your pads. Tender touch. Snickers. You can lay down for this.
This is all matte right here. When it's tight to the ear leather like that, I don't really like to do that because I'm afraid I'm going to cut the ear. I'm just going to end this whole ear. Inside of the 40. And those have knots all around. You can see the knots over here too. It's just right here at the tip. So lift this here up.
Actually, I'm actually going to start this right out. Mostly with the problem. No, I'm so mad. It's just thick. If you don't get all the mats up, you're not doing your job. $75 Got it off the Amazon. You can also get it from Pedigree. Pedigree, A-G-R-E-E. On top of the ears, I'm going to do a foam over them. See what a C looks like. Because I want to do my comb over it so it doesn't look so silly. It's more like a layered ear. Small afro, bottoms of feet cut short, but tops of feet regular length, ears longer but still trimmed. Well, unfortunately, with his ears being matted as they were, there's really so much I can do. So then, if we're going to do a small top knot, I'm just going to trim up the face then, since they want a doodle cut and a poodle cut. We'll do a burnt comb on the face as well. We're going to do sort of E comb goes to the top knot. Doodles, we usually do like, say they're close on them. States, they're going to be the C-Tone, which is a 7/8 of an inch. The E-Tone has literally an inch. The base is just really going to shape up. There's really not much that's coming off the face of the website. That's a spine. Okay. I know yours might not be what you wanted. They're matted like they were around the edges. So it's best for the pepperoni. That stuff to happen could get to the point to where, you know, the whole ear would have to be shaved. I think he might actually look really good with your ears. I shave my people's ears, but I leave like a little tassel at the bottom. Sometimes I have to cut that short, but sometimes I get to have it. Sometimes I'll just shave it a little. Thank you.
This is my version of a doodle cut, y'all. It's 5/8 all over. I did an E-comb on the head. I did a C-comb on the face. The C-comb really didn't take anything off. So pretty much I just shaved it up. But this is the cut. He is all set and ready to go home. He's so handsome. I'm so handsome. I'm going to spray some of the Irish tweed on him that I have left. I want this stuff to smell so good. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.